Hey friends, welcome back to the top of our giant ocean tank with our aquarist Lindsay. Today we are going to talk a little bit about target training. If you've been tuning in regularly to our virtual visits, you're probably a little familiar with target training. We primarily talked about target training our sharks, and of course our marine mammals get a lot of that training as well. But today we are going to talk about training another animal. We're going to talk about training our great barracuda. All right, Lindsay, can you maybe start off, why on earth are we target training a barracuda?
Yeah, sure thing. Well, similar to our sharks, our barracuda also falls into that predator category. So really, our target training is focusing on having him associate his food coming from us, the dive staff, instead of hunting on his own in the giant ocean tank, which would not be great for all of his tank mates. But additionally, target training is really excellent. They have a strong association with a target, you could begin to add layers to that, maybe a hammock similar to our shark hammock or something else, which then allows the staff to get really good observations on that animal and even make it easier to collect them once they get bigger, because our great barracuda is just a youngster right now. He's only about a foot, maybe a foot and a half long, but when they reach adulthood they can be over 3 feet long, so having a well-trained barracuda will definitely come in handy in the future.
Amazing. So now that we know why we're training him, maybe we can talk a little bit about how we do that training.
Sure. So it takes a lot of repetition and it's done by baby steps. So when our great barracuda first arrived with us in January, he started out in a pen that we put into the giant ocean tank, just to allow him to acclimate and get used to all the new sights and sounds. And it was actually a floating pen that was located just off of the platform here.
Cool.
And in that pen, we used a very small target. It was black and white striped. And every day when we fed him, we would put that target up to start that association with, I see this target, I'm going to get food. Once his acclimation was complete and we released him from that pen, then we had to upgrade the scale of the target. So this is his target now. A little bit bigger than the other one.
Definitely noticeable. Yeah.
And so we've been working with having him see this target now from a much larger area, and orienting towards this target, and then is rewarded with food. And now it's going pretty well, but being a young barracuda, he's still a little timid. Sometimes he gets outcompeted by some other animals in the tank, and he'll definitely get more comfortable with it as time goes on.
Awesome. Well, that actually brings me to my next question, Lindsay. How long have you been working on this target training with the great barracuda?
Yeah, so it started right when he got here in January, and he's definitely made leaps and bounds from where he was, but we're still a little bit away from our end goal.
So not great at it yet, but definitely working on it.
He's young.
He's learning. So we are going to attempt to show you this target feeding today. As Lindsay mentioned, he might be interested. He might be not be, but that's okay. We're gonna give it a whirl. So let's check it out. Shall we show him, Lindsay?
Sure thing.
Awesome.
So the goal is eventually to have this be hanging on any glass panel in the tank, but right now we tend to submerge it off of the platform.
And here he comes right towards us. You can see he's that kind of torpedo-shaped fish that's hovering just over the coral.
Let's see. Gonna go, bud? Yeah.
Nice. The other cool thing to keep an eye out for, if you are looking carefully as he's headed over to grab that food, barracuda can actually change the pattern of their bodies. And when they are hunting, they typically get this very distinctive stripe pattern. So if you ever see a barracuda looking really stripy in the giant ocean tank, he's probably hungry, looking for some food, or maybe in the middle of a target feeding. So we'll see if he's going to do this again for us.
Yeah, so he's coming over here right over the top of the reef. Good job. He's having a good day.
Yeah, he's feeding like a champ today.
Now the goal is, once he really gets comfortable with this and is approaching really well, then we can add in those second steps of getting him comfortable with a hammock or something else that would allow him to kind of swim through. Which would be really great for us to get really close, good looks at him every day for his feedings.
Awesome. So as our mammal trainers have talked about a few times, target training is a great way to get animals to participate in their own health care. And for fish, that often means getting nice and close so we can get a good look at them, monitor their feeding behaviors, and sometimes, like our sharks, swimming through an object which can help us remove them from the exhibit if they need an exam or they need to be transferred to another exhibit. Looks like he's considering coming back for some more.
Could we go 3 for 3? Woo-hoo!
Not faster than the jack that time.
No, yeah, the jacks are pretty keen to finding things that might go into the tank, especially if it's food-like, so they can be a little quicker sometimes. One baby step in the target training process for our great barracuda was once released from the acclimation pen, our divers would actually take the target and wear it as part of their backplate harness used for diving, and would bring that target even closer to the barracuda. And so you can see here our diver wearing the target. It's nice and close, and then as the barracuda approaches, it was stick fed, which was a really great way to get it really close to the divers and comfortable around us. And now we've been working on backing it off further and further away and still getting that response.
So looks like he might be done for the day, but that's all right. The other really cool thing about training is that it's animal led, so it's based on what they want to do. Again, with that positive reinforcement of food, like Lindsay mentioned earlier. So I think at this point, Lindsay, we'll go ahead and wrap it up. Thank you so much for showing us another really cool glimpse into daily care of our animals here in the giant ocean tank. If you guys have questions about target training, about great barracudas, about Lindsay's job here at the aquarium, put them in the comments. We will answer them for you. If you don't have questions, that's fine too. Just tune in again tomorrow to learn a little bit more about life here at the aquarium. Thanks, friends.